You were hurt by someone you trusted?
Yeah.
Like the family member who abused you?
Yeah.
Which made you feel powerless again? It's cool. She released this.
Wow, when I saw that scene from Atlanta, I knew I had to talk about it on this week's Cross Connection because it's really not something we see on TV every day, and that's Black men in therapy. And of course, you may remember Kendrick Lamar's album, which dropped this summer, that also explores this very timely topic. Now, according to researchers, Black men are about half as likely to pursue counseling as their white counterparts when experiencing anxiety or depression. Well, the first step in breaking that stigma is to talk about it. And so here with me is Dr. Michael A. Lindsay. He's dean of the NYU Silver School of Social Work, and back with us is Dr. Jason Johnson. Mike, I want to start with you. Dr. Mike, my Morehouse man on set with me. Great to have you here with me on set, seriously. And I just, you know, I've noticed that this conversation around therapy and Black men is becoming normalized, but maybe not normalized to the extent which it needs to be. Why do you think that's happening now?
Well, I think the pandemic has certainly had an impact on how people are being in touch with their emotions and their psychology, if you will. People are being encouraged to talk about how the pandemic has impacted them. And I think it's a great thing because for so long, there's been so much stigma related to talking about these issues. And so, you know, the time is really perfect for us to be having these conversations because so many people are hurting as a result of what has transpired in the pandemic.
Yeah, it's nice to see. Jason, I'm putting you on the spot a little bit, all up in your biz. But seriously, have you gone to therapy before?
I have, and I actually really debated as to whether I was gonna answer this question, because it's not so much a fear of threatened masculinity. I just never wanted to really talk about it. But yes, I actually had a therapist. I was uncomfortable, frankly, and I felt like the world doesn't need to know. But you realize that having conversations with the other brothers in my life about their therapy journeys have been helpful. I was in therapy when I was in school because I thought, oh, maybe I'm
undergrad,
just stressed.
High school?
Graduate school when I was getting my doctorate.
Okay.
Because I thought, oh, maybe I'm just stressed. But it's like, oh, no, this is anxiety. I'm not sleeping. I'm not eating well. And it was a critical part of me moving forward. And I had the rare experience, and I'd love to hear what Dr. Lindsay thinks about this. I actually had a very good experience with a white therapist.
Mm.
Since then, I've never interacted with a white therapist, but I had a white male therapist who the first thing he said to me is, are you comfortable with talking to a white guy about this? Because I understand if you're not. So that's what built a really good relationship.
That makes a really good point, though, because there does seem to be a necessity for cultural competency when talking to, so when we talk about Black men in therapy, there's also a delta when it comes to Black men therapists.
That's right.
So how can that be addressed?
So what we know is that only about 4% of the mental health workforce are actually Black.
Wow.
And so as a dean of a school of social work, the Silver School of Social Work, it's really important for me to bridge that divide by bringing more people of color, people from historically marginalized populations into the profession, showing them that, you know, you can do well if you come into the behavioral health workforce. And so, you know, to Jason's point, I think that so many people struggle with, I want to see a Black therapist. I want to see someone that looks like me. And I often tell folks the most important thing is to see someone.
Yeah.
Right. And then work it out. Just like we have to go to various beauticians or barbers until we find the right fit. You know, sometimes we have to go through that process until we get the right one.
Yeah.
But to go to someone is really, really critical.
That's the-